Welcome to Aarti's Education. This is the second part of practice set 24. In this video, we are going to solve the questions from 2 to 5. Before we start, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe my channel for more videos. So let's solve our remaining questions here. The second question is, if large square beds of equal size are to be made for planting vegetables on a plot of land 18 meters long and 15 meters wide, what is the maximum possible length of each bed? Here we have to find out the maximum possible length of beds for planting vegetables on a plot. For it, we have to find out the factors of 18 and 15, then common factors between them, and we have to find out the SCF for these numbers so we can get the maximum possible length. Here they ask maximum possible length means we have to find out our HCF here. It's very easy. Let's solve it. Question number 2's answer is, the size of a plot is 18 meters long and 15 meters wide. So we have to find out HCF for 18 and 15. Let's find here HCF of 18 and 15. One is the factor of each and every number. So our first factor for 18 is 1. Then it is divisible by 2. It is divisible by 3 also. Then it is divisible by 6. 6 3 is 18. 9 2 is 18. And 18 1 is 18. These are the factors of 18. Now let's find out the factors of 15. Here 1 is the factor of 15. Each and every number have 1 as a factor. Then 15 is divisible by 3. It is divisible by 5. And 15 ones are 15. So the factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. Now here, let us find out common factors. Common factors are 1, 3 is common factor here, and we can see only 1 and 3 we can find as a common factor, 1 and 3. Here we have to find out our SCF. HCF is 3. So the maximum possible length for each bed is 3 meters. Let's write it in words. The maximum possible length for bed, each bed, is 3 meters. Now let's look third question. The question is, two ropes, one 8 meter long and the other 12 meter long, are to be cut into pieces of the same length. There are two ropes and they will be cut into pieces of same length. what will the maximum possible length of each piece be? Here we have to find out the maximum possible length, means HCF. It's very easy. The length of two ropes are 8 and 12. So first of all, we are going to find out the factors, then common factors, and then our HCF. Our HCF is our question's answer. So let's find out 8 and 12's HCF. For question number 3, answer is 8 meter long and 12 meter long. So let's find out the factors. Here 1 is the first factor of 8, then second factor is 2. It is divisible by 4 also, and 8 ones are 8. Now 12 factors are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Let's find out here common factors. Common factors of 8 and 12 are 1, then we can see here 2 as a common, and 4. So the common factors of 8 and 12 are 1, 2 and 4. Here our HCF is 4, because 4 is the highest number here. And our answer for the maximum possible length of each piece is 4 meter. Write here in words the maximum possible length for each piece is 4 meter. Now the fourth question. The number of students of standard 6th and standard 7th who went to visit the Tadoba Tiger Project at Chandrapur was 140 and 196 respectively. There are 140 students of 6th standard and 196 students of 7th standard. The students of each class are to be divided into groups of the same number of students. Each group can have a paid guide. What is the maximum number of students there can be in each group? Why do you think each group should have the maximum possible number of students? Here we have to find out the answer for two questions. First of all, we are going to find out here the HCF of 140 and 196. So can we know our first question's answer, that each group have how many students there, and then we are going to write the answer of our second question. So let's find out the HCF of 140 and 196. For question number 4, the answer is 140 and 196. Let's find out the factors of 140. The first factor is 1. It has 0 in the unit place. So second factor is 2. Then it is divisible by 4. also divisible by 5 because it have 0 in the unit place. Then it is divisible by 7, 10, then 14, 20. 20 is the factor of 140. Then it is divisible by 28 also. Then 35, then 70, and last factor is 140. 141 are 140. Now let's find out the factors of 196. It is divisible by 1, so 1 is the factor of 196. Then it has 6 in the unit place, so it is divisible 2 also. Then 4 is the factor of 196. Next factor is 7, 14, 28. We can find it in 49's table also. Then we can find it in 98's table and 196's table. So let's find out here common factors. Common factors of 140 and 196 are 1, 2, then we can see here 4, 7 is also common factor here, then 14, then we can see here 28, now common factors here are 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28. 28 is the highest number here. So here the HCF for 140 and 196 is 28. This is our first question's answer. That is, what is the maximum number of students there can be in each group? So the maximum number of students there can be are 28. Right here in words, there can be 28 students in each group. The second question they ask us is, why do you think each group should have the maximum possible number of students? So it can be easy to handle the students also and to appoint a guide on them, and there will be a minimum number of groups also. So when there will be a minimum number of groups, we appoint minimum number of paid guides. So can they save their money? Now the fifth question. At the Rice Research Center at Tumsar, there are 2,610 kg of seeds of the Basmati variety and 1,980 kg of the Indrayani variety. If the maximum possible weight of seeds has to be filled to make bags of equal weight, what should be the weight of each bag? And the second question is, how many bags of each variety will there be? So let's find out here. First of all, we are going to find out the HCF of 2,610 and 1,980. So we can find out the maximum possible weight of seeds has to be filled to make bags of equal weight. Let's solve the question. Question 5's answer is, First of all, we are going to write here the factors of 2610. They are each and every number have one as a factor. So first factor of 2610 is 1. Then it have 0 in the unit place, so it is divisible by 2. Its sum is 9. So 9 is divisible by 3, so this number is also divisible by 3. Then 5, 6, also 9. Then it have 0 in the unit place, so it can be divisible by 10. Then 15 is the factor of 2610. Then the next factor is 18, 29, 30, 45, 58 is also the factor of 2610. Then we can see it in 87's table also, 19's table also, then 145, 174, 261, 290, 435, 522, 870. Then we can see it in 1305 and 2610. Now let's find out the factors of 1980. Here the divisibility tests are useful to you to finding out the factors, and also you can find it by dividing the numbers 1, 2. It have 0 in the unit place, so we can say that 2 is the factor of 1980. Then it is divisible by 3 also. 4 is the factor of 1980. 5 also. Next factor is 6. Then 9. It have 0 in the unit place, so it is also divisible by 10. 11. Then it is divisible by 12, also divisible by 15, 18, 20, 22, 30, it is divisible by 33 also, then 36 also, 44, 45, then we can say that it is divisible by 55 also, 60 also. Let's look here, 1980, 6 ones are 6, 6 threes are 18, 1 is remaining here, and 1 and 8 makes the number 18. So 6 3 is 18. So it is divisible by 60 also, like this. And the 60 is the factor of 1980. Then it is divisible by 66 also, 90 also, 99, 110. Then it is divisible by 132 also, 165 also, 180, then 198, 198 tens are 1980. Then it is divisible by 220, 330 also, Also, it is divisible by 396, 495, 660, 990, and it is divisible by 1980. Now, let's find out here the common factors. Common factors for 2610 and 1980 are, let's encircle them. 1, we can find here 3, 2, then 3, 5 also, 6, 9, 10, then we can see here 15 is also the common factor, 18 also, then 30 also, then it is 45 also, 87, the here is no 87, we can see here 90 also, 145, 174, 261, okay. So, up to 90, there are common factors, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, 15, 18, 30, 45, and 90 are the common factors of both numbers. Here 90 is the highest number, so our SCF is 90. So each and every bag have the maximum possible weight of seeds is 90 kg. So we can write here, it should be 90 kg weight of each bag. Now the second question they ask us, how many bags of each variety will there be? So for finding out, we have to divide the weight and the kilograms of each variety. Let's divide it so we can find out our second question's answer. 2610 divided by 90 0 will be cancelled here. 9 ones are 9 and 9 threes are 20, 9 twos are here, 9 twos are 18, 8 is remaining here. Now the number is 81, 9 nines are 81. So we can say here 29 bags of basmati rice . Now for Indrayani rice, we have to divide 1980 by 90. Let's cut here zeros. 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 1 is remaining here and 9 twos are 18. 22 is the answer here. So we can say that 22 bags of Indrayani rice. So this is the solution of our practice set 24. I hope you will understand it very well. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.